Hi to all, and today we are here to discuss a poem Abou Ben Adhem written by Leigh. तो आप सभी का स्वागत है आपके अपने ही चैनल एक्सेलेंस लर्नर में, जहां आज हम लोग इकट्ठा हुए हैं बात करने के लिए एक पोएम अबू बेन एडम, जिसके रचयिता हैं लेह, राइट? सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ पोएम अबू बेन एडम बाय लेह ऑन योर फेवरेट चैनल एक्सेलेंस लर्नर. ओके, so Leigh was an English critic and poet. His full name was James Henry Leigh, and this particular poem Abou Ben Adhem is the part of syllabus for the student of ICSE board of class 9 and 10. So we are here supposed to discuss line by line, word by word of this present poem, Abou Ben Adhem, right? This poem was first time published in year 1834. This is a narrative poem. The poet uses here the storytelling technique. And during the course of telling the story, he convey a profound reflection and lesson, right? And the lesson is that, this is a very profound lesson behind this poem, and the lesson is that loving one's fellow man, loving God's fellow man, is fact, is perhaps more virtuous than loving the Almighty Himself. ईश्वर को प्रेम करने से कहीं बेहतर है ईश्वर के सपूतों को, ईश्वर के फॉलोअर को, ईश्वर के फॉलोमैन को प्रेम करना. यह इस कविता का सेंटर थीम है. सो दिस इज द सेंटर थीम ऑफ दिस पोएम अबू बेन एडम, एंड इन दैट पोएम द लेशन इज वेरी क्लियरली एंड विविडली स्केच्ड एंड डिपिक्टेड बाय द पोएट लेह. Let's now go into the poem, right? Okay, so I start. Abou Ben Adhem, may his tribe increase, awoke one night from a deep dream of peace, and saw within the moon light in his room, making it rich and like a lily in bloom, and angel writing in a book, right? So the very first stanza of this present poem of the day, Abou Ben Adhem. उसके बाद हम देख रहे हैं एक ब्रैकेट में लिखा हुआ है may his tribe increase. So this is the literally praising, मतलब Abou Ben Adhem कवि की इच्छा है, कामना है, may this tribe increase, इस तरह के लोग ज्यादा हों. He is wishing, he is praising that this type of person, which type of person? Person like Abou Ben Adhem must be increased, must be multiplied in number on the earth, because this type of man is really the man of the earth, right? So this great person, Abou Ben Adhem, awoke one night from a deep dream of peace. One night he awoke. From where? Deep dream of peace. यहाँ पर D का आप देख रहे हैं alliteration है, and of peace is a symbolic word. Of peace, गहरी नींद से. The person who is really satisfied, the person who has no need in present, the person who is content in fact, get and sleep in the deep dream. So this word symbolizes that Abou Ben Adhem is the man of satisfaction. He is totally content fellow. One day he awoke sorry, one night in fact, he awoke from a deep dream. Ek raat vah apni gahri nidra se jagta hai. To kya dekhta hai and saw within the moonlight in his room, wo dekhta hai ki uske ghar mein moon ki light pad rahi hai. Right? It is also a symbolic word. Moonlight means the light of calm, the light of cool in his room, and this light making his room rich, really. The person who has no need is the richest person of the world. Jis vyakti ke paas koi avashyakta nahi ho, jisne apni avashyaktaon ka daman kar liya ho, वह व्यक्ति संसार का सबसे धनी व्यक्ति है. और पहले ही हमें बता दिया गया है कि अबू बेन एदम वाज इन डीप ड्रीम ऑफ पीस. दैट्स व्हाई सी वाज द ही इज द पर्सन हु हैज नो एनी अर्थली नीड. ही इज टोटली सैटिस्फाइड एंड कंटेंट फेलो. दैट्स व्हाई हिज रूम इज फुल ऑफ रिचेस. राइट. एंड फिर यहां पर एक सिमली का यूज करते हुए कभी कहते हैं लाइक ए लिली इन ब्लूम. जब लिली खिलती है, लिली इट इज द नेम ऑफ ए फ्लावर यू नो, व्हेन इट ब्लूम्स रियली इट ट्रांस इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स द ब्यूटी द काम द ट्रांक्वालिटी द सेम टाइप ऑफ फीलिंग द सेम टाइप ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन कैन बी सीन इन द रूम ऑफ अबू बेन एदम. सो अबू बेन एदम के कमरे में चारों ओर धन बिखरा हुआ था, रिच था बना हुआ उसका रूम, क्योंकि अबू बेन एदम एक सेटिस्फाइड पर्सन है. और एक रात जब वह नींद से जगा तो उसने देखा, क्या देखा, कि एक एंजल राइटिंग इन ए बुक ऑफ गोल्ड. यहाँ पर गोल्ड भी देखिए, गोल्ड इट इज द सिंबल ऑफ रिचनेस, एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड इट इज ऑल्सो सिम्बॉल ऑफ प्योर एंड प्योरिटी. सो एक प्योर बुक में, एक पायस बुक में Angel means the messenger of the God is writing something. So this is the sum total meaning of the first stanza. Exceeding peace had made Ben Adam bold, and the presence in room he said, "What writest thou?" The vision raised his head and with a look made of all sweet accord answered, the name of those who love the God. Exceeding peace. Exceeding matlab bahut jyada. In the very first stanza, we have been already introduced that Abou Ben Adhem was the man of satisfaction, content person he was. That's why he was very much bold. वह चूंकि पूर्ण रूप से संतुष्ट व्यक्ति था, इसलिए वह bold भी था. There was no sign of fearness in his character and his behavior. So exceeding peace had made Ben Adhem bold. क्यों भाई, क्यों bold हो गया? अचानक रात में यदि हम किसी को अपने रूम में पाएं तो निश्चित तौर पर एक डर की लहर सी दौड़ाती है. But Abou Ben Adhem is bold, so he has nothing to fear. He is fearless totally, and he asked the question to the angel that was present in his room and asked directly. What he asked? What writest thou? Writest thou, olden Angrezi mein use kiya jata tha. Jahan iska use kiya hai kabhi nahi humare liye. That means, what are you writing? He asked question directly to the angel about what it was writing over here. The vision raised his head and with a look made of all sweet accord. The vision here, it is also a symbolic word that means angel. The vision raised his head, apna shar uthate hue, because he was busy in writing names. So when the question is asked from Abou Ben, by Abou Ben in fact, she raised her head and answered very sweet accord. Sweet accord means with good manner, with good disposition, because you know angel is the messenger of God. That's why it has good disposition. It raised his head and answered with good disposition, good sweet accord, that the name of those who love the God. Means in that book, the angel is writing the name of the person who loves God. Right? This is the sum total meaning of the second stanza. Let us proceed and go into the next stanza, right? Chaliye, dusre stanza mein hum log pravesh karte hain. And his mind won, asked, said Abu. Nay, not so, replied the angel. Abu spoke more low, but cheerfully still, and said, I pray thee, then write me as one that love his fellow man. So, knowing that the angel here writing the name of a person who loves God, Abu was overwhelmed. एकदम सा उत्तेजित सा हो उठा, ओवरवेम, खुशी से वो लगभग पागल सा हो उठा और उसने कहा, निश्चित रूप से मेरा नाम उसमें होगा. एंड इज माइंड वन, सेड अबू. ने, नॉट सो, रिप्लाइड द एंजल. लेकिन उसकी आशा के विपरीत, ही वॉज होपिंग दैट हिज नेम विल श्योर इन दैट बुक, इन दैट लिस्ट. बट ओ माई गॉड, द एंजल रिप्लाइड इन negative. It said that his name is not there. Knowing the fact his name is not here, Abu got a little bit disappointment. He was a little bit worried, but we know his actual nature, he is satisfied. He is a satisfied person. He is a content person. So very soon he wiped off, he erased off his disappointment, and with actual happiness, right, and cheerfulness, he said and requested to the angel to write his name as one that love his fellow man, right? So that time we get here that Abu Ben Adhem is in such a position to pray, suggest and request to the angel to write his name in such a book, such a list, in fact, where it's supposed to write the name of a person who loves the fellow man of the God, right? जानकर कि उसका नाम उस लिस्ट में नहीं है, अबू बेन को थोड़ी देर के लिए असंतुष्टि तो जरूर हुई, लेकिन फिर भी क्योंकि हम लोग जान चुके हैं कि अबू बेन एक संतुष्ट पर्सन है, एक सेटिस्फाइड कंटेंट फेलो है, उसने कहा, उसने रिक्वेस्ट किया एंजल को कि उसका नाम उस बुक में लिख दिया जाए जिस बुक में उस व्यक्ति का नाम हो जो ईश्वर के सपूतों से प्यार करते हों, ऐसा लिस्ट में उसका नाम लिखा जाए, राइट? सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ योर सेकेंड थर्ड स्टेंजा. इन फैक्ट now we are in the last stanza, the fourth. The angel wrote and vanished. The next night it came again. The next night it came again with a great awakening light. Vanished. The next night it came again with a great awakening light and showed the name who loved the God had blessed. And lo, Ben Adam's name led all the rest. So after taking the request of Ben Adhem, that night the angel disappeared, means vanished. Vanished means disappeared, in fact. And the next night it came again with a great awakening light. Great awakening light. It is also a symbolic word. That means with new research, with new contentment, with new disposition, right? So agli raat when angel fir se aati hai aur is baar wo naye utsah, nayi khoj, nayi soch ke sath uske samne prastut hoti hai, and showed the name who loved the God had blessed. Today angel not here to write anything else. In fact, she
seeking, she comes today to show the list of a person, the list of a fellow who loves the fellow man of the God. Right? And lo, Ben Adhem's name led all the rest. Lo, lo is a word of exclamation, exclamatory word, and the word of surprise, in fact. So surprisingly, today the situation is that Ben Adhem's name led all the rest. Among a long list of a person, among the long list of a man who love God, today angel showed, today Abou Ben Adhem gets his name top of the list. Means he is the person, he is the best person, he is the superior person, in fact, who loves the fellow of the God. Right? So it is that sum total meaning of this poem, Abou Ben Adhem. Now it is time for us to discuss some figure of speech that has been used in this poem. Right? First, alliteration. Alliteration is the figure of speech in which the repetition of same sound in the nearby word is used in this poem. So, ek hi tarah ke sound, ek hi tarah ka letter use kiya jata hai nearby word mein. Aur ye alliteration do prakar ka hota hai, hame pata hai na aapko? Ek hota hai assonance. Assonance means the repetition of vowel sound. Aur dusra hota hai consonance, the repetation of consonant sound. Correct. To dekh lete hain. Abou Ben Adhem, पहला लाइन जो आपकी पोएट्री का है, इसमें ई और ई का रिपीटेशन बेन एंड एडम में दिखाई पड़ता है. सो इट इज द रिपीटेशन ऑफ ई वर्ड, ई साउंड, एंड इट इज द सेम एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एसोनेंस. दूसरी ओर डीप ड्रीम भी मिलता है मुझे कविता में, यहां पर डी का रिपीटेशन है, इट इज द कॉन्सोनेंस. राइट? इस कविता में सिमली का भी यूज हुआ है, लाइक ए लीली इन ब्लूम, इस वर्ड में सिमली का यूज हुआ है. राइट? आर्किज्म, आर्किज्म मतलब होता है पुराने वर्ड को, द वर्ड दैट इज नॉट इन यूज एंड फैशन इन प्रेजेंट इंग्लिश बट इट वाज यूज्ड इन ओल्डर इंग्लिश. इन फैक्ट दिस टाइप ऑफ वर्ड इफ इट इज यूज्ड इन द पोएट्री इट इज कॉल्ड आर्किज्म. एंड हियर आर्किज्म इज यूज्ड, जैसे कि व्हाट राइटेस्ट दाउ, ये ओल्डन इंग्लिश में यूज होता था, जहाँ इसका यूज हुआ है तो ये आर्किज्म है. फिर एक वर्ड आपको इसमें मिलता है ने, इट इज ऑल्सो एन, इट इज ऑल्सो एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आर्किज्म. सो दे आर द सम फिगर ऑफ स्पीच दैट हैज बीन यूज इन दिस पोम. राइट? ना अब समय है आपसे कुछ बातें कर लेने का. बच्चों, मुझे पक्का विश्वास है कि आपको यह पोएम अब समझ में आ गई होगी. एक बार इस वीडियो को देखने के बाद आप अपने से पोएम को फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट टू लास्ट पढ़ेंगे, एंड आई एम श्योर यू विल गेट द मीनिंग वर्ड बाय वर्ड ऑफ दिस पोएम. राइट? जैसे मैंने कहा, इट इज़ योर चैनल नॉट माइन, सो यू आर द ऑनर ऑफ दिस चैनल, एंड डेफिनेटली बीइंग अ ऑनर ऑफ यू ऑफ दिस चैनल, इट मस्ट बी योर डिजायर टू स्प्रेड द चैनल फार एंड वाइड. राइट? सो डू वन थिंग, just keep viewing my channel, write your comments and share as much as you possible so that I get new ideas to put some study material in that channel time to time. Should update the channel frequently, because you know your these comments, your subscription works like a booster and tonic for me, and at the same time, with the help of this tonic, I put materials for you people. I make you sure, after going through my videos, you need not to do any extra coaching or class for English particularly. And one more information and announcement, in fact, I want to share with you. After completing all poems, I will start the series of Merchant of Venice, act by act, scene by scene for you people to make understand. And then I will start the question and answer session with you people as per the question that has been given in your workbook. So just keep viewing my channel and sharing, and try to subscribe much and more, right? Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.